One thing that we're commonly asked to do in regards to linear functions is to evaluate them at certain places. And so in this video, I just want to talk about that for a minute. So if your function is expressed as f of x equals, let's say, 2x plus 5, then to evaluate it, what that means is they want you to take this x value out and all the x values in your function and replace them with a certain number or letter or something like that, usually a number. So for example, if they wanted f of 2, then that means they want you to evaluate your function when x is 2, because what you're doing is you're replacing x by the number 2. So let's replace x with the number 2 on the right-hand side as well to find f of 2. So we'll have 2 times 2 plus 5 instead of 2 times x plus 5. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 plus 5 makes 9. So f of 2 would be 9. And the way we could express this graphically is this line, this linear function, goes through the point 2 comma 9, because again, 2 is the x value, where 9 being the output would be the y value. All right, let's try this again. Let's do f of negative 3. Evaluate the function when x is negative 3. We'll take the x out and replace it with a negative 3. So we'd have 2 times negative 3 plus 5. 2 times negative 3 is negative 6, and negative 6 plus 5 makes negative 1. So a point, another point on the graph of this linear function would be negative 3 comma negative 1. That's an xy value. All right, now in closing with evaluating functions, we don't have to evaluate functions just at numerical values. We can evaluate functions at variables or even whole expressions, like this last example, f of a minus 1. So this often confuses students, but it is not as bad as it sounds. All we're going to do is we'll take f of x, and everywhere that there used to be an x, like here, we're going to take it out. So we'll have 2 times blank plus 5. Usually I'll put a blank in wherever an x used to be, and I'll replace that expression, that x, with an a minus 1. So instead of 2x plus 5, it'll be 2 a minus 1 plus 5. And the only thing I'll caution you against is to remember that the a minus 1 has to go in as a packet together in parentheses. So we can clean this up a little bit. If we distributed the 2, we'd have 2a minus 2 plus 5, and then that would give us 2a plus 3. That's minus 2 plus 5. So now this might concern you a little bit that we did not get a numerical value for our answer, but that's no problem at all because we did not plug in a numerical value. We plugged in a minus 1. Our answer has a in it, not surprisingly. So anyways, this is how we evaluate different linear functions. Now, the last thing I want to talk about in this video is a closely related problem to evaluating functions that oftentimes gives students a lot of trouble. So let me show it to you. It says if f of x equals 2x plus 5, like it did on the previous page, then they want us to find an x value such that f of x would equal negative 7. They're not saying take negative 7 and plug it in. They're asking what x values would give us negative 7 as an answer. So for this, what we're going to do is we'll take f of x, we'll take the 2x plus 5, and then we'll set this function equal to negative 7 because it's basically like asking a question, what x values, if you plug it in, will make f of x equal 7. So just the thing to remember is that we're not plugging negative 7 into the function. We're setting the function equal to negative 7 and solving for x. Once we realize that, it's all downhill from there. We'll solve for x. We'll subtract 5 from both sides. So 2x equals negative 12. To solve for x, we'll divide both sides by 2. And so x would equal negative 6. So let's read the question again and let's make sure this answer makes sense. We were looking for an x value such that f of that x value would give us negative 7. Let's try it. Let's see, you know, now that we're done, we're finished with the problem, let's just see out of curiosity, what is f of negative 6? Well, let's try it. 2 times negative 6 is negative 12. Negative 12 plus 5 does in fact give us negative 7. So just remember, we're not plugging in negative 7. We're setting the function equal to negative 7 and solving. So anyways, these are two common types of exercises you'll see relating to evaluating a function at a certain place.